What up, bitches? It's the misanthropic one, aka He Who Hungers. And I'm back up in this bitch for another rant slash review. Today, I want to talk about this album right here. Drake's sophomore effort titled Take Care. Not going to waste any time going into the history of Drake. Y'all already know. If you want to know about Drake, go check my review for his last album, Thank Me Later. And, not Thank Me Later, but his album called Thank Me Later. And, I'm going to get right into it because most of y'all already know about Drake. And I'm going to get right into this shit. I don't want to waste any fucking time. Producers on this album. This album, a lot of the tracks were mostly produced by a guy named Noah 40 Shabib. I don't know if that's how you say his name. And you also have T-Minus. You have Just Blaze on one track called Lord Knows. You also have at the end Doc McKinney and The Weeknd, and also Boy Wonder is on here as a co-producer for what song is that? Headlines. Y'all probably heard that shit all over the radio. Well, I wouldn't know because I don't listen to radio, but my man, Mike Vallone, tells me that they play the shit out of that song on the radio. Features on this album. You have The Weeknd, you got Rihanna, Birdman, Nicki Minaj, Rick Ross, Andre 3000, and of course you're going to have Lil Wayne on this album. It wouldn't be complete without Lil Wayne and Nicki Minaj on a Drake album. Before I get into this whole album review or synopsis, I'm going to say this again because I know a lot of people are expecting me to bash this album and shit, but like I said in my last video, I don't mind Drake. I don't think he's horrible. I think he's oversaturated, you know, they play him the fuck out, they play him everywhere, you know, I believe that he has his own lane in hip-hop, and I read shit where he's comfortable making his style of music, he's comfortable making music for women, and geared towards women, and I like that. He's being honest with himself. He's not coming off like he's some fucking street nigga and shit. And I like that, you know. As long as you're honest with yourself, that's the biggest problem in hip-hop right now. All this pop bullshit comes out and motherfuckers are bigging it up like certain motherfuckers are like the best in the fucking world when they're not, or they're hardcore or this and that. And Drake knows his fucking place, you know. And that's why I could respect him. He's not my favorite fucking rapper in the world. I'm not saying that. I'm just saying I can understand where he comes from. And that's why I don't fucking bash him anytime I hear his fucking name. But with that said, the vibe of this album, y'all should already know. Very similar to his last album. Beats very melodic. Very light. They compliment his style, you know. He's not hard, like I said. He doesn't come off, you know, like a gangster or nothing like that. The beats fit his style, like I said, and it kind of makes the record go together smoothly. So let me get into this album real quick. Love how it starts off with the song Over My Dead Body. Just Drake going in, mixing his rapping with the singing like he always does. Let me move forward. I like the track Crew Love, which is track 4. I like that primarily because of the production on it. The production was fucking crazy. I really like how it was simple, but it was somewhat different from what he usually sings or raps over. That track is primarily a singing track. Let's see. Marvin's Room, y'all already heard that shit. Underground Kings, dope fucking track. I love that. That's another track where Drake goes in just straight rapping, talking about his come up. And he also admits, again, in that song that he raps about bitches and shit. I forget the line he says. Something about, they say, all I do is, all I know about is rapping bitches or rap and bitches. Some shit like that. Just listen to the song. I really like that track. That's one of my favorite tracks. I'm gonna fast forward to another one of my favorite tracks on here, Lord Knows, featuring Rick Ross. Dope fucking beat. Again, Drake straight rapping in it. And then Rick Ross comes in and raps his ass off too. Gave a pretty dope verse. And I know a lot of y'all probably don't like Rick Ross, my subscribers, but listen to Rick Ross's verse. It's pretty ill. And like I said before in other reviews, I came around and I actually am a fan of Rick Ross now. I don't like his like early shit, like 2006 and all that. But what was it? When did he come out? Yeah, 2005, 2006, around there. I don't like that early shit, but like after Deeper Than Rap, you know, went Deeper Than Rap, and his latest one came out, I believe. Those two albums are really, really fucking good albums. Just listen to them. What else? The Real Her featuring Dre 3000. Another decent track. Obviously, you know what the subject matter is about based on the fucking title. The thing I like most about this track is hearing Dre 3000 go back in again. And, you know, he is supposedly working on a new Outkast album or whatever. And, you know, I haven't heard him rap in a while. Well, that's not true. He was on Tech N9ne's album. Lil Wayne's album. Sorry. He was on Lil Wayne's album, and he was rapping on there, and I'm glad to hear he still has it. Next track I want to talk about is Hell Yeah Fucking Right, but on the back of the CD, it's HYFR, because they didn't want to put curses on the back or whatever, but Hell Yeah Fucking Right, featuring Lil Wayne. The thing that stands out for me on this track is the fact that Drake is rapping almost at double time on it in certain bars. Like he's rapping, you know, how he usually does, and then he'll just speed it up and shit. And Lil Wayne manages to mimic him on his verse. And I thought that was pretty clever. In conclusion, this album, in a nutshell, how it felt to me was really an R&B album in the guise of a rap album, if that makes any sense. This album, I like a little bit less than Thank Me Later. This album is more fit towards females. I think that goes without fucking saying. Females will be all over this album, and they will eat it up like candy. They'll think that this is a classic fucking album. Me personally, I can't see myself really rocking this album like that unless I was trying to seduce a female or fuck or whatever. Well, that's not true. I would go back to it if you know, just out of the blue, I might go back to it just to listen to it. But it really wouldn't be something that I'm dying to listen to or anything. So my rating of this album is, I would give it like a maybe like a 6 to 6.5. There were some songs on here where Drake is going in, but again, a lot of subject matter, y'all know how I feel about that shit. You know, if you're constantly on that chick shit and not really being creative about it, that kind of kills it for me. But I suggest to people, just listen to it. Even if you're not really a Drake fan, I'm sure that you can find some shit on here that you could appreciate. And that's it. There's my Take Care album review. Oh, I forgot to mention, there's a lot of singing on this album. So that's why I said that comment earlier, that it's really an R&B album in the guise of a rap album. And not to say there's no rapping on here, but yeah, there it is. That's it. So y'all know the deal. I'm fucking it up. Leave your love, leave your hate. Support good music, and that's all I gotta say. Alright? Stay tuned for more rants and reviews. Peace, bitches.